Welcome back to the channel. This is Never Too Old to Rock. I'm your host, Jim. You call me Jim. If you're new to the channel, welcome. If you're already a subscriber, then you are fucking amazing. You are. I mean that sincerely. You are. If you're just clicking onto the channel just to see what the channel's about, you know, shooting the breeze, that sort of thing. Well, I'll tell you, it's about reactions to rock and roll, rock, metal, anything in between that sounds, you know, like it's got a bit of a kick to it. That's fine. And some 80s music. Now, I throw in the 80s music because not all of it was crap. There was some good stuff in there, and I enjoyed listening to them. And I continue to enjoy listening to them to this day. So, you know, it brings back some good memories for me. So that's why I put them in anyway. And the fact that it's my channel and I can do that. Sorry. Yeah, but that's what I do anyway. So how is everyone on this very hot afternoon? Well, I think we're at 33 degrees. And it's fucking hot out there. Tomorrow, it's supposed to be 34 or whatever, something like that. See, us in England, we're not used to very hot weather like this. Usually it's pissing down and cloudy and rainy. Because we live in England and it's that type of country. It's fucked up. The weather's fucked up, politicians are fucked up, everyone's views is fucked up. It's fucked up. So, welcome to England. Anyway, what have I got for you today? Going to back to I think so, around about that time. And there wasn't really much happening in the world of rock that I liked. There wasn't much happening. Not in 2002. In 2002 I actually stopped listening. Because I thought the music today is just so bad. I just listened to the sort of like the old stuff. And I was quite happy. You know. And then this came on. It's Marilyn Manson, Tainted Love. Now the original, I can't remember who the original was, but it came out in the '80s. I can't remember his fucking name. Mark Almond. No, I get it. He did the original. So this is a cover. I don't know. When I heard this, I thought, actually, it's not that bad, actually. I don't mind this one. Yeah. I mean, I wasn't a fan of Marilyn Manson because it just looked weird. You know, he was more of a shock person. He wanted to go out and shock people. And that's fine if you're into that, you know, then hey, knock yourselves out. I'm not going to stop you. But it just didn't do anything for me. But when he released this, I thought, okay, no, it's not bad. It's not perfect, but it's not bad. And the other day, I was driving in the car, radio on, and it came on. And I found myself singing along to it. So I thought, I don't know, I'm going to do a reaction. See what you guys think. This is Marilyn Manson, Tainted Love. Here we go. My view on Marilyn Manson. He's alright, I suppose. I just never got into that sort of goth look. It wasn't my scene. I mean, up until let's say 2005, I had the long hair, I had the biker jacket. You know, up until 2005, that's what I was dressed as. And then suddenly, you know, bad thing happened to me. My dad died, and I don't know, I sort of I had a the doctors said I was so close to having a breakdown, because I wasn't coping. And then, you know, I was trying to do everything that I could to sort of not feel the way I was feeling. So I was spending more, getting into debt. I was trying not to feel how, you know, I was probably sort of running away from myself. And then my best friend said that I needed a kick out the backside. During that time, if you had seen me walking down the street, I was in a world of my own. I didn't acknowledge anyone. I had tunnel vision. And all I could see was, don't talk to people, don't do this, just go. Because I knew the first question they would ask was, how you feeling? I didn't want to sort of let them know, so I was blanking everyone. And that went on for about 6 years. And I was a mess, and at the end, I looked like fucking Marilyn Manson. And then, she just says, you need to kick up your arse. You need to get yourself sorted. Can't let it dominate you. And she was right. And suddenly the grey hair started turning up. And I thought, I'm getting older now. I need to put a lid on this. So I cut my hair. After I did that, I felt like a brand new me. And I started going back into rock music. And I thought, well, I'm going to have to sort of start where I finished, and that was 2002. And this song, so this is probably the last sort of rock song that I had listened to back then. And I banged it on, and I listened to it. And suddenly my love for rock music came back. Because I was out of sorts, it was a rough time. Suddenly, I put this on. So, now I dug out all my old albums and I thought, I haven't heard this in a while. Bang it on. Suddenly, the world made sense again. That's the power of rock music. Whether it's Marilyn Manson or Iron Maiden or Guns N' Roses or Avenged Sevenfold or whatever floats your boat. But yeah, people who don't understand the power of rock music, you're fucking morons. You really are, because it gives you that lift. It's got energy to it. So anyone that badmouths rock and metal, I say that. Because, you know, even rock and roll, you know, whether you hate it or whatever, if it wasn't for guys like that, who paved the way so that for music to evolve, you know, that's why I love it so much. I do. Anyway, enough about that. Don't want to keep dragging that shit up. You know, it's in my past and that's where it's staying. Yes, I know that sometimes I get doubts of the depression coming in and whatever, but most of it, you know, I'm pretty cool. So I get people saying to me, why don't you do some pop music? Why don't you do this? Well, I don't want to. It's got nothing for me. Sorry, but no. I'm not saying that's got a bit of energy. Something that makes me feel alive. So, yeah. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. Please leave a like. Please subscribe. Please check out my other videos. And with that, I shall say, I will catch you all in the next one. Peace.